Don't tell the gods I left a mess, I can't undo what has been done.
Hello and welcome to episode 12 of the 90 Minutes, I'm Danathan743.
I'm Max743.
And...
Chaz743.
There we go, it's Chaz743. Absolutely wonderful. There we go. Episode 12, let's go on to our first topic. Sadio Mane, a player who plays for Southampton, scored the Premier League's fastest ever hat-trick last weekend. And it was just an unbelievable thing, wouldn't you say? What are you doing?
I was laughing at who are they playing?
Aston Villa.
I was laughing at Aston Villa. They're surely defending. That's why.
Yes. Okay. And, but it was.
Oh, it was pretty amazing. I didn't watch it live, of course, I watched our match today.
Yeah.
Pretty surprised. It could have been prevented, most of the goals.
Oh, okay. Were they good goals? Would you say?
Average.
Okay, average. Thank you, John.
Standard.
Average. That's
but a few goalkeeping errors.
Certainly, it's a very and it was an unbelievable time. It was sort of 3 minutes, something like that, to score the previous record. Of course, Robbie Fowler with his 1:04 minutes and something, and nobody thought I would ever be beaten. But absolutely unbelievable stuff from Mane. How would you feel if you were to score a hat trick within this time? It's
pretty happy.
Well.
Yeah. See, I've scored many hat tricks,
Of course.
I've scored 4 goals against Napoli. Pretty simple.
Really?
The only time Charlie ever scores hat tricks is in his own net.
Oh, that's funny, and that's funny.
Oh!
He's gonna play some like cool music, like.
Yeah, I will do. Yeah.
Cheers. Put that in.
Just like that. That's exactly what it sounds like. But how does it feel to score a hat trick?
Well, when I scored my hat trick, you know, when we won 18-0, I felt pretty happy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, how did it feel when you scored your hat trick in the own goal?
I don't know why everybody's still on about that. That was so long ago.
What happened?
Scored no goal.
It was going wide.
It was going wide. And he
really?
Gets it back.
That's what everybody thinks. It wasn't going wide.
It was.
Okay. Let's move on from this awkward situation to the next topic, which is transfer hopefuls.
He's got a hat trick. Still better than him anyway.
Okay, there we go. Transfer hopefuls is where we're going to discuss each of our teams and what player we would put into each of the positions of goalkeeper, defence, midfield and attack. So we'll start with goalkeeper. And for Everton, I would say Achiuwa, who currently plays for Malaga. And I think that'd be a good signing. He's done very well in the World Cup. I think he could bring a lot to Everton to replace Tim Howard. Max, for goalkeeper, who would you go for?
Lot of hopefuls, but I would say Roberto, the Olympiacos keeper, Spanish guy.
Okay.
I've heard some good things about him, and he's young, I think he's 25 or 26. A lot of you guys won't know, but he's a very consistent goalkeeper. I think Olympiacos, top of the Greek league, the Hellas Liga, and yeah, it'd be great to have him in the club.
Okay, Charlie is a goalkeeper.
Yeah, I'd say Courtois.
Do you think it would be best to keep De Gea? Would that be a big thing for you?
Yeah, De Gea's a really good keeper.
So, I mean, just getting him to sign his contract would be a massive thing for Man United. Yeah. On to defence. For me, I'd go for, and this is quite unlikely because he's only just moved, but Marcin Stasic. He's just moved permanently to Schalke from Man City. But, you know, if he doesn't feel at home in Germany, we'd be happy to give him a home at Goodison. And, you know, he's a good young, I think he's 21 or 22, quality young defender. You could pair up with John Stones, and I like the idea of that partnership. Max, who would you be looking at?
Well, there's a few good players I like. Number one for me would be Luke Shaw, as I don't think he's at his full potential.
That's interesting.
I'd say that he's not his full potential at Man United. I haven't really heard much of him, really.
No.
He hasn't done much. He's a lot better at Southampton.
Yeah.
And that's the case with most players when they go to... They're superstars and they go to big clubs and they kind of fail.
So
I think it would be great if he was at West Ham.
Very sad. Charlie, can you think of a defensive player?
Yeah, I'd say Kompany.
Kompany.
Do you think it's likely that he's going to make that controversial switch?
Probably not.
No. We've seen it happen before sometimes.
And it does happen.
He's a very good defender.
Sol Campbell, definitely.
But, okay, Charlie is building just the base... Basically the best Premier League team possible.
Yeah, what's what you need.
Well, you know, that'd be pretty good for Man United to be up there again. A midfielder, I'm going to have a think. Oh, actually, Leroy Fer. He started off at Norwich.
Fair, but yeah.
he went to QPR. Of course, they've got relegated. So a player that Everton have looked at in the past, and you know, he's a young midfielder, quite a attackive, I'd say, quite attackive player. And Charlie, good.
I'm good.
And so I reckon he'd be fitting in well, perhaps, if Barkley does leave for 40 million, which I'm sure he will do, then then he could fill his role. Max, midfielder.
Barkley is rubbish.
Yeah, I agree. But anyway, I would like... I'm a big fan of the kind of players that are coming to end of their time in football. So ones that are past the 31 year mark. Okay. Just because I feel like they still have some life left in them, you know, as a footballer.
So what about last season when QPR signed Rio Ferdinand? Was that... Did he still have some life in him?
I would have liked him at West Ham.
Really? Okay.
Yeah.
Well...
But yeah, he's been all right.
Okay.
Yeah,
of course, so hasn't been good. Which ancient midfielder are you going to bring into your team?
I wouldn't mind. Well, midfielders aren't normally the best place to bring in an ancient midfielder.
That is true.
Because they still need a lot of stamina and stuff.
True.
But I would like Marouane Fellaini.
Okay.
Because I don't think he's...
I think he's doing very well at Man United, actually. He's started to...
I think, yeah, he's finally doing what he needs to do. We don't have a solid CDM at the moment.
Song will probably leave.
Song is, he's going to go back to Barcelona.
Yeah.
And he's going to leave then.
Okay.
There's a few players we've been trying to sign, a Spanish midfielder, whose name I can't remember at this time, but I hadn't heard of him, so he can't be that good. And he's quite young player. Apparently he's maybe good, but
there you go.
We'll see.
Charlie, any midfielders that Man United might like to sign?
I don't think they need to sign anyone midfielders.
You think the midfield is absolutely perfect?
Well, not perfect.
So at the moment, who's in your midfield? Who would start in your midfield?
I'd say... I'm not too sure, to be honest, because there are quite a few good midfielders for Man United.
There are.
I'm not really...
Yeah, I don't think they've really quite sorted out there.
Yeah.
Herrera's got done quite well, actually. Yeah. Fellaini's got in there, but... So they're starting to find that centre midfield player they've really been searching for. As the striking position, I can say no other than Nikita Jelinek, and I shall tell you for why. I shall tell you because on the BBC gossip column today, I was scrolling up and down and I read that Jelinek said if Hull get relegated today in about 2 hours' time, that could happen. If it happens, he would like a loan return to the Premier League. And could it be to his former club? Who knows? But that sentiment that he left with the club,
one question,
he could bring a bit of spark.
One
please,
question.
Please,
if you
fire away.
If he came to West Ham,
yeah,
which West Ham are looking for another striker, apparently.
Okay.
Would you be happy? If he, would you like root for West Ham sometimes then? Because I know you sometimes root for Hull.
I do. Yes. That's a very interesting call.
West Ham?
And. I think I would root for him. I would want him to score goals. But
not West Ham.
Yeah, just.
All
right. I'll try.
I would say, you have to educate me on his first name. Ndoye for Hull.
Damn Ndoye.
I think he's a great player. You know, I think they only signed him this season.
January.
Yep. So he probably won't come. But
in the Russian league.
We need that Senegalese link that we've got with. with Diafra Sakho and Kiate. Now we're thinking of signing Demba Ba, who actually just got a pack team and season card there.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. You guys can check that in the behind the scenes vlog. But that's who I'd like.
There you go. Charlie, a striking force for Man United.
Peter Crouch.
Yeah, I think that's interesting. The giraffe man, Max, you would agree.
Yeah,
right.
Giraffe.
So it sounds like Falcao might not make his move permanent. Mm. Van Persie might leave. And who does that leave you with, really? Well, Rooney perhaps playing up front, but you certainly need at least one, if not two more, striking options at Manchester United.
You should re-sign Federico Makeda.
That is the answer to all those problems.
Andy Carroll.
Andy Carroll, yeah. Good call.
He'd get injured on the way to the medical.
Yeah. The FA Cup final is happening next weekend. We are going to now talk about our predictions for that game, what we think is going to happen. It's going to be the two A-teams, of course, Arsenal and Aston Villa. So, Max, how do you reckon the game is going to pan out?
Aston Villa are going to get thumped by Arsenal.
Thumped.
Thumped.
Tell me why.
Thumped.
like that.
Don't buy it.
Why is that?
Because it's Aston Villa. And
they're rubbish.
Okay, well, you know what? They got to the... they beat West Brom. And West Brom beat you 4-0. So if Aston Villa are rubbish, what does that make West Ham?
Good.
Like 11th?
Okay.
Anyway. Right, I've got more. First of all,
okay.
We had many injuries. No recognisable strikers.
Strikers?
We had Emmanuel Onorarse playing.
Who?
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. Ever heard of Emmanuel Onorarse? Leave...
Leave
a dislike if you know Emmanuel Onorarse. There you go. No one's going to leave one. No one knows him.
Okay, and Charlie, do you reckon Aston Villa have got any chance in this FA Cup final?
No.
No?
No, simply no.
Who's... No. What sort of scoreline you think? Will they score a goal?
I think it's going to be about 3-0 to Arsenal.
3-0? Yeah. And Max, what will your prediction be?
I've got a good plan. Like, if they were struggling, if, like, Aston Villa was struggling, they could, like, try and get Charlie to play for Arsenal, and they could, then he could score his own goals.
Okay. Oh, I like that. That's a good plan. I like that.
Yeah.
Or they could just bring on you and you score a hat-trick.
Yeah.
So simple as that. My prediction, I think, probably 3-1. I reckon Aston Villa can get a goal, but I think they'll be dominant. I have done a second simulation video, which is of the FA Cup final. That'll be up later this week, so have a look out for that. See what FIFA thinks will happen in that game. We'll quickly also talk about today, as we're filming, just about 10 minutes to go until the final games of the season kick off. Relegation is a big worry for, of course, Hull and
Newcastle.
So, who's going to get relegated, guys?
Well, I really want to say Newcastle. I know in my family, my sister supports Newcastle only because of her boyfriend.
Okay, and for that reason, you're just going
to... I would like them to get relegated because, you know, they're playing West Ham. It's on Sky Sports, so we can watch it on Sky Go.
Great.
Sky Go.
Got an account there. Simple.
Great stuff.
And I wanted Sunderland to go down. Nathan.
Okay. But they're safe now. Yeah, so you reckon... But the likelihood is, unless Manchester...
I would like Hull to go down, because I would like to see Nikita Jelic in the Premier League play for West Ham.
Oh, great.
But...
Okay.
But then I wouldn't really want Newcastle to go down, because I want to see Newcastle play West Ham again.
Okay.
It's a good rivalry in our household.
Okay. There you go. Well, there you go. There's some predictions for the relegation battle that's going to go on today. It's now time for the challenge. Let's take a look.
Hey guys, Dan to the 743 here. Here is the challenge for this week. So what we're going to be doing, we're going to have two contestants for each round. One standing here, one standing here. We'll have a goalkeeper in the goal over there. What they'll be doing, they'll be asking questions to the two contestants here. And the person who gets the question right, if they get it right, they get to take a first-time shot into the goal. If they get it wrong, the other person takes the shot. Let's get to it.
What a finish, son.
Have you ever seen a worse penalty? I know I've missed. Well, two of mine have been saved. And you look at him, he's distraught.
Sorry.
Dan, the guess you've got an A.
Yeah.
Learn that one now. Everton sucks!
How much does a $0.99
cost? Max.
Yeah.
Oh, 99p.
Oh, yeah, I know.
What?
Yeah, like I dumb, I know. Okay.
Yeah. Oh! No!
Actually,
vote death.
I'm pretty sure it's Sunderland. It's Sunderland.
Dan. 0-0. Dan. 0-0.
What? It's not even fair.
It's stupid. This match doesn't seem so bad.
Oh. Where is Jasker Island from?
Dan.
Huh?
Yeah. Excuse me, running up. Oh, quality fence.
Who is my favourite player?
Max Van Persie.
Yeah. Oh,
again!
Moment out of 50. Dan say that most people wouldn't put it in there.
Max.
Yeah?
You mean Adrian Pedersen?
Yes!
What?
Yeah!
Oh,
so you said that, Dan?
Yeah. Adrian!
No!
What? No, Max!
Yes!
No,
yes!
Match fixing! Match fixing!
We are the
heroes! No, why?
Yes! So we are back from the challenge. We're going to move on to the goal of the week. The goal of the week this week, a very skillful goal. And Max, would you like to take us through it, please?
Right, so I'm not sure who this is for. I think it's for, it's a Polish league team. But a lovely pass in there. Look at that, lovely. Oh, he's going to take the shot. No, he's not. Oh, he just backheeled it around all of them.
Unbelievable.
It literally cannot do anything about that.
Extreme confidence here. Lovely. The amount of
look
touches he takes.
The backheel's just so cool. It's amazing how he does that. Look at this. Oh, beautiful.
Oh, I think it flicked on there,
didn't it? Yeah. Oh, I didn't notice that before. Mm. No, he could shoot there. The other thing he's going to do, I just backheeled around everyone. Keeper lets it in. Joe, you know a lot of that. Good stuff.
Quality goal. The vote this week. Who scored the goal of the season between the best goal for each of our clubs? Obviously, I've gone with Jeggy over against Liverpool. Certainly, the most important, surely, of all the three goals. Got that equaliser in the 90th minute in the Merseyside derby against Liverpool. Then you got Enner Valencia's cracker against Hull, and you got Wayne Rooney's fantastic touch and then smash in against. I can't remember who that was against.
Was it against Hull? Might have been it. No, they
just
played today.
Not sure, but it was in
Aston Villa. Yeah.
In that, you know, that weekend where it was. An unbelievable selection of fantastic goals. The birthday boy this week, a player who's really thrived under Alan Pardew in his half-season spell at Crystal Palace. It is Yannick Bolasie, who alongside Wilfried Zaha have been two of the star players for the team. He is full of skills, pace, trickery, and so I'm sure there'll be plenty of highlights for me to pick from. So enjoy Yannick Bolasie's skills. A couple of things to look out for. Please go and check out the almighty reaction to when we watched West Ham versus Everton. Very exciting time. Max, you can see, is trying to wipe away the tears from his eyes there. Very sad. Also, we've started a new series, our top 50 moments, where we're recreating our top footballing moments. So, look out for that as well. The first one's up, which is Rob Green's blunder in the World Cup.
Great one.
Please like, subscribe, I've been Dancing 743.
I'm Max 743.
I'm Charleston, full free.
See you next time.
Bye.
Good night.
Don't tell the gods I left a mess, I can't undo what has been done. Let's run for cover. What if I'm the only hero left? You better fire off your gun. Once and forever. He said, go dry your eyes and live your life like there is no tomorrow's sun.